Ovde sam u bašti Augarten palate ovde u Beču. Muzika koju čujete je proba bečkih dečaka. Jedan naš bečki dečak je razlog zašto sam došla ovde da napravim ovu emisiju.
Dvorcu, ovde inače škola, salon gde isto pevamo ponekad koncerte, neke male privatne i tu su sve ti probe saloni, tako da kažemo, tu sva četiri hora probaju.
Dobili smo dozvolu, idemo na probu bečkih dečaka ovde u Beču. Ja ne znam da li je Marković otišao da nas sačeka, ali ovo je izuzetna prilika. Jedna je stvar kada ih vi vidite na sceni, onako uredne stoje, a druga je stvar da ih vidimo kad vežbaju. To je to. To je ta proba. Kapelmeister daje instrukcije. Hello. Thank you for having me. Thank you very, very much. Where are you from?
Me? Originally Hong Kong.
Lovely, lovely.
Actually.
Yes. And those are the children here.
Yes.
Are you very severe with them?
Yes, of course.
I came because of Marko Dmitrievich, and he's coming from my country. And I would like very much that I attend this rehearsal. And I would like very much to talk to you and to some children,
yes,
okay?
No yes.
I'll wait for a few minutes.
Feel free and enjoy.
Yeah. Thank you. Drugčije izgleda, a drugčije na bini. Drugčije.
My name is Tina Breckwald and I'm the researcher and archivist here and sometimes in charge of programs and things we do.
I heard that you are here 23 years surrounded with children. What you would tell me? What is the feeling?
It's very nice and very privileged because there's always someone young around and they're always eager to learn. They're always curious, interested in life, and it's full of life and full of music, which is very nice.
Tell me, how do you feel when they leave? Because they leave in a certain age, because their voices are not anymore the voices of what is needed, you know? How do you feel when they leave?
Well, they don't leave forever. Some of them go on and continue to the university entrance exam. And quite a few of the others, they all come back. They come back and visit and we know what they become. And that's very nice to see that they kind of have a spot for us in their hearts and that this means something to them, these 4 years that they are on the road in the boys' choir and on the road as a group. That is very important to them. And I think it's a bit like a small state, if you will, a small society, whose goal it is to make music. And that would be an excellent goal for most politicians, wouldn't it?
Tell me, when they come back to you after they left the choir, how do you feel?
I think that's a very nice, it's the best compliment you could get. The nicest compliment from a small child or a child in the choir is when they listen and when they just seem to be happy. And the nicest compliment from somebody coming back is that they do come back and that they smile and reminisce and seem to have appreciated what they've got here.
Ovo je koncert za nas. Baš lepo. Thank you. Thank you so much. You have the fantastic job.
Yes, well, yes.
Surrounded with children.
Yes.
And with children with the best voices.
Yes, in fact, yes.
Okay. Who was laughing?
Well, you know, they are always really, really critical about themselves, of course.
Are they?
Yes.
You make them critical?
Well, but that's important for life.
Tell me. How? What do you tell them?
Well, I think is one has to set a really higher goal. And when we're doing music, yeah. And on one hand we should have fun, but on the other hand I think the discipline is very important, and that's what we are trying to educate here. And I think that's important for lives, and that's we have to set our level of living higher. And so I think that one can learn also through music training.
Do they know that they are in the most respected music institution in Europe and even larger?
Yes, I think so.
They understand that?
Yes.
Even their small children, they do understand?
Well, because, maybe when not necessarily when they first arrive or when they come over from our Volksschule, but when once they dressed it in their uniforms, and of course, when you know, sometimes they've experienced when they're walking on the street. One time we were actually even in the mountains, we were filming for another occasions in a Alm, what we call. In Austria, and then all of a sudden someone just ride the bike, some, I don't know who were they from, and they say, oh, are you the Wiener Sängerknaben? So they just see, by seeing just simply the uniform, they already know. So that gives them already already immediately, oh, well, we are being watched. And sometimes, and of course, on social media, and there are a lot of fans, and so they are aware of it.
You know, I came to Vienna because somebody from my country is a member of Vienna Voice, okay?
Yes,
this is him.
And that's Marco.
Okay.
Yes.
What do you think about him?
Oh, he's a wonderful guy. And I know him, of course, and in fact, our meeting was a very interesting because he came in summer where we were have a training camp. Mm-hmm. And then he impressed me by the first sight, by how he already be motivated. And for me, it's very important to see it in one's eyes and in their heart that they are motivated and love to do this. So on one hand, you can train them a lot of techniques. And I don't need to look for the highest talent here, but I need to look for a heart.
That I'm here because Marko Dimitrijević is a member, right?
Yes,
and
yes,
thank you very much for having me during the rehearsal. And I heard that he did by himself, poem, right?
Yes, well, he's been showing through the years more interest in writing songs, and he has a lot of ideas, and he improvises on the piano, and I have been coaching his pianos playing and also writing music. And then it comes to a point that he has these songs called I Show You the World, and he had many other songs. He writes also his own text and things. And so I also, this is also our institute's motive to support their singing, but not just singing, but also in general music education. So
in fact, you support all musical talents,
yes,
in a way.
Yes.
Some music skills.
Yes, yes,
right?
Of course. And they all have to play some instruments, and so, and I thought that's a good thing. And so we work on this piece, and we have a choir version, which we also sometimes sing. So.
Tell me, I heard a very, very famous Nish Gabanya.
Mm-hmm.
How come?
Well, it just came to our mind. Well, of course, it's a famous Serbian song and children's song, I think, right? And since we also have Marko in the choir, so of course we sing. We like to sing also. We have a new CD, in fact, it's called Together, where we actually record a lot of these songs from all over the world. And the idea is that through music, we are one.
No. This is the message.
That's the concept, together.
We are one.
Yes.
Aren't we?
Yes.
Yes. Ovde je sve jako strikto. Osobe koje ovde vidite, koji se obraćaju ovoj deci, dobijaju instrukcije. Šta posle ovih vežbi, šta će se raditi tokom dana, treba da idu na ručak i tačno je sve određeno u minutu. To su njihovi vaspitači. Marko, ja bih molila da mi ispričate šta je ono što sledi posle ovih proba. Jer ste vi ovde u internatu. Pa ćete mi pokazati malo baštu, malo napolje i da mi ispričate kako izgleda vaš život. I šta je ono što ćete uraditi posle?
Pa, život jednog bečkog dečaka je inače tako da posle proba onda imamo jelo i imamo pauzu sat i po vremena, tako, i onda odmah počinje škola. Znači, mi smo mnogo vredni, mnogo nam vredan dan. I tako, mi radimo dosta i uvek smo zaposleni.
Da li je to pritisak? Imam utisak da je sve ograničeno u minut. Da se tačno sve zna kad se šta radi, jel da?
Kad novo dolaziš u bečke dečake, malo je teško, čudno je, novo je, naravno. Ali sada ja sam već u četvrtoj godini i meni se to, ja sam se navikao na to. I meni je tako život isto, to je isto lekcija jedna, isto sad sve brže radim u životu generalno. To ima nešto veze.
Znate šta, ja ću vas moliti da me odvedete vašim roditeljima, pa ću ja njih pitati kako je to sve izgledalo, da vi dođete ovde i počnete da pevate u ovom horu. Da vidim šta je ono što pored ovoga radite, šta je ono što su vaši planovi, jel važi?
Važi.
I'll show you the world for Marko.
Tamo je naš internat i mi smo odmah tu pored škole, imamo tamo jedan stakleni prolaz.
Da.
Gde možemo da obučemo papuče. Doručkujemo ujutru, obučemo papuče i idemo odmah u školu. Za manje od jednog minuta smo tamo.
Stvarno?
Da.
Jeste zakasnili nekada?
Ne. To bi bilo malo čudno, pošto nema razloga da zakasniš. Inače, uvek kad ideš u jednu drugu školu koja je daleko, uvek kažeš ja zakasnim, mislim, bus ili tako ono. Ovde si direktno tu i niko tu ne kasni i sve je tu po planu, sve je dobro.
Sve je po planu?
Da. Moji roditelji žive već 20 godina ovde u Beču i evo ovo je moja kuća. Živim, ja sam se rodio u Beču tu i da, hteo bi da sretnete moje roditelje. Može?
Pa hvala.
Ja hoću u budućem životu bilo šta sa umetnost da radim, hoću da glumim. Imam sad 14 godina, a kad imam 20 ili u buduće vreme, stvarno hoću nešto da radim sa umetnost. I pored pevanja u horu Bečkih dečaka i pisanje pesma, isto glumim u jednom musicalu. U Snežani i sedam patuljaka glumim princa i lovca.
In Liebe ist mein Herzenbrand vom ersten Augenblick. Wenn ich sie nie mehr finden kann, erfüllt sich nie mein Glück. Ich suche sie schon überall, kommt sie denn nicht zurück?
Hteo bi još jednu kompoziciju da vam pokažem. Hero se zove moja pesma.
Heroj.
Heroj, super heroj. I sa tom pesmom, inače kad sam napisao tu pesmu, hteo sam jednu pesmu da imam koja objasni, o kojoj objašnjava mišljenje od jednog deteta. Šta mislim s time? Jedno dete hoće sve da bude. Sve da bude, hoće da bude super heroj, vatrogasac, astronaut, to sve, sve hoće da bude. I bukvalno u toj pesmi hoću da kažem, hoću da naučim svaki jezik od japanskog do nemačkog, hoću da letim, da imam snagu kao Herkules i da. Tu pesmu sam za manje od 7 minuta napisao, pošto sam stvarno pričao iz srca šta ja mislim, šta svako dete misli.
I wanna go to Mars and be the first one there. I wanna be famous so I can fly everywhere. I wanna have loads of money like Bruno Mars. I wanna be a billionaire. I wanna be a hero. I wanna be a superhero. I wanna save other people's lives so they're not scared but just smile. I wanna be a hero, I wanna be a superhero. I wanna save other people's lives so they're not scared but happy for the rest of their lives.
Bilo mi je teško malo kad mi nisu bili roditelji tu svakog momenta, ali iako nisu tu pored mene, tu su. Već osjećam, oni su uvek kod mene i zato ja nisam baš uvek plakao, nisam bio tužan. Ja sam bio uvek jedno raspoloženo dete. Šta je isto za druge bilo malo čudno na sceni i iznad scene. Ali ja uvek imam osmeh na licu, pošto uvek vidim dobro u svemu. Vi vidite da ja ne pričam možda tako dobro srpski. Naravno, ja pričam kući samo srpski, ali ja sam ceo dan u školi gde samo pričamo nemački. I ja naravno probam da usavršim srpski jezik, hoću najbolje da pričam što mogu.
Kada sam bila na probi, čula sam izvođenje Niške banje.
Kad smo pevali tu pesmu i na koncertima i na probama i sve. Inače, uvek je na latinskom, na nemačkom, na svim drugim jezikama, ali na srpskom, kad smo pevali prvi put, nešto baš me udarilo u srce, baš mi je bilo lepo da na mom jeziku pevaju jednu pesmu i to mi baš značilo, da.
It doesn't matter how often you get kicked around, how many people tell you that you are a clown. Don't care about the past is gone, care about the future, cause it's your...
Prvi susret kada smo sa nekim, da kažemo, malim problemčićem je bilo kada je trebao da ostane u internat, znate. Tu ste u Beču, ste odjednom vaše dete u internatu. Ali kasnije, kada smo videli da je Marko tamo predivno i da je tamo sa drugarima i, da kažemo, ima jedan ispunjen dan, zanimljiv, onda smo i mi to prihvatili, ali bilo malo teško na početku. A kasnije smo onako malo se zapitali, ja, malo dete, mi ga pusti smo u svet. Trebali su da idu na neka velika putovanja, odnosno na turne.
Kako vam godina?
10.
10-11, da.
Kako ste vi to doživjeli?
Pa znate kako, upravo što kaže za internat, on se nikad nije odvajao od nas od kad se rodio. To je bilo prvo odvajanje, onako je bilo. Onako, prva dva dana, gledamo se po kući, hvali nam nešto, nema nam deteta, neobična situacija, ali je posle...
Posle smo se, da.
Posle sve super.
I onda smo zaključili da zapravo, kad vam dete peva u takoj jednoj instituciji, nije to samo pevanje, to zahteva, onda sam rekla, Ljubiša, bili bi zaista sebični kada bi sada kukali za detetom i nego opusti se, dajmo mu podršku i pošto je sve tamo naravno funkcioniše u najboljem redu, onda smo i mi postali, da kažem, opušteni i srećni. Dok nisu došle turneje i onda smo mi tako otišli, znate kakva je srpska majka, mora i ona da vidi gde je dete, tako da smo po neki put i putovali da ga posjetimo tamo i da vidimo.
Tom prilikom kada ste putovali, šta ste primećivali?
Pa oni su mnogo poštovani, mnogo traženi, mnogo u celom svetu. Sve su sale bile prodate svude, znači od Kine, Azije, znači do Amerike, mislim da su svi koncerti bili rasprodati. Ja sam uvijek govorio, oni su kao mali Beatlesi, ono, kad su ulazili u autobuse, toliko su fanova imali, imaju fan grupe po celom svetu. I onako interesantno je nam je bilo, što prvo videti uopšte takvu taj događaj sa tom malom decom, a pogotovo što naše dete peva tu unutra.
Biti bečki dečak znači i značilo je da je Marko 4 godine proveo u horu. Za to vreme se školovao u privatnoj gimnaziji koja pripada bečkim dečacima. Dobio je muzičko, vrhunsko mogu da kažem, obrazovanje. A za uzvrat Marko peva i nastupa u horu. To je podrazumevalo, mislim da nam je to bilo okej.
Okay. On u stvari svojim pevanjem obezbeđuje svoje školovanje.
Tako bi rekli, jeste, tako dođe. Zato što mi ne plaćamo ništa, nismo plaćali ove 4 godine ni školovanje, ni muzičko, ni ovo osnovno, ni internat. Pre 2 godine odlučili smo da ga posetimo na rođendan.
njegov rođendan, ono, odlučili smo, detetu je rođendan, daleko je, jeste Kina, ali roditelji kreću, upakujemo se i odlazimo. I tamo smo doživjeli zaista lepe trenutke na njegov rođendan, sala od 5-6 hiljada ljudi, tako je bilo. Marko spontano, u stvari na podluci kapelmajstora, radi solo Strausa i pred prepunom salom, onako sa publikom, navija i poziva, motiviše publiku da i ona aplaudira, učestvuje u pesmi. To je onako bio zaista lep događaj.